It's Amy Sky with Cincy Chic, and
I'm Amy Elberfeld with Styling with Amy, and I'm also an independent stylist with Night Guard Style Direct.
We're here this week for another episode of Styling with Amy and Amy, and usually we're telling you about fashion tips and trends and what to get, but now we're going to tell you, we're putting the mom hat on, we're going to tell you what to do and how to care for them once you actually get the clothes in your wardrobe and how to make them last as long as possible. So what is your number one tip?
My number one tip is that most items should not go in the dryer. The dryer causes shrinkage, it causes your colors to fade, wear and tear on your clothes. So I recommend that you do machine wash cold delicate on almost everything that you own. Then you can either use a drying rack, which you can find anywhere, you know, Amazon, Bed Bath & Beyond, wherever, or I just read a blog about these hangers, and they're called Bumps Be Gone hangers, and they're flexible. Well, I'm not doing a very good job, but you can flex them so you shouldn't have any bumps in your clothing. So I have not tried these yet, but yeah. I think they look like an interesting concept if you want to hang. And you can also, I use my shower rod to hang things to dry overnight, but, or like I said, a drying rack.
Yeah, because the heat from that dryer is really damaging to your clothes.
Yes.
What are some other tips?
If you do not already have a garment wash bag, these are great, and they actually come in a large enough size. Sometimes we think just doing bras or something in these, but actually these are great for delicate sweaters, and they actually make the bags large enough that you could even fit like a cardigan sweater in it and machine wash it delicate your washing machine.
Or if it has any like hardware or anything like that, it's something that can protect your washer and dryer
Absolutely.
Too. Absolutely. So what are some other tips?
The other thing is these are called Shout Color Catchers. And one thing you want to remember, if you buy a new pair of dark denim jeans or anything that's red, you should really wash it before you wear it because if you would sit on any light furniture or they get wet, the color could transfer to other clothing you're wearing or to a white couch or whatever. So make sure you wash it a couple of times before you wear it, and the Shout will collect that extra dye that's in there, so that's another good tip.
Okay.
Also, if you're a workout girl and you have the wicking type fabrics either in your workout gear, you never ever want to use fabric softener. It plugs up those, whatever that fabric is.
The pores.
Moisture, it's moisture wicking, and it will not wick the moisture anymore.
Good
and they're
tip.
Also, not your clothing, but it's also very bad for towels because they lose absorbency. So do not use fabric softener with your towels.
I
know it
know
makes
that.
Them soft, but they won't absorb the water.
Yeah.
Another tip, if you do have things that are dry clean, my dry cleaner gave me some advice that I'd never heard a couple years ago because I took something to him and he said, you never want to try to take care of it yourself and then take it to the dry cleaner. So if you have an expensive item or something that's dry cleanable and you spill something on it, don't try to fix it yourself because whatever you may use at home may set the stain or make it more difficult for your dry cleaner to get it out. So just take it straight to them and handle them.
All right.
A couple other quick things is if you travel a lot, you can on Amazon buy something called Forever New that comes in little packets. It's great for everything washable, and you can just travel with these little packets if you need to do any washing.
And that's a good brand. I use some like delicate fabric care. That is a really good brand.
Yes, and they also have little bottles of granulars. Mm-hmm. And then the other thing is if you hate an iron and an ironing board, I use this all the time, and this is a, like they call it a travel steamer, but you fill the reservoir with water and it's great. You know, you can have your clothing on a hanger and steam the wrinkles out. It's very portable. If I need to bring it to a shoot we're doing to steam anything out, or if you're traveling. So
those it works just as well, if not better than an iron.
Yes, absolutely.
That's all you have to say to me.
Yes.
All right, lots of great information on your website, and that website is stylingwithamy.com.